clustering. We all know what is the basic difference between clustering and classification. Clustering is unsupervised, no output variable. You take the raw data, try to bucket them into groups based on similarity of the data. Similarity between data items in the same cluster and heterogeneity with data from other cluster. And that is used even in the context of unstructured data. Can you give me an example?
Recognizing the numbers.
That is exact classes, right? You are exactly detecting.
Right.
But if you want to group similar pictures into different groups, for example, what today some of the very intelligent file systems, what they do is they look at your data and automatically try to group similar documents into one thing. Then maybe a human comes and actually looks at if they are all similar clusters, but it removes a lot of time. It reduces a lot of time for sorting the whole set of files. Same thing, you look at images, you want to group them. Which are the images which are related to maybe this game, which are related to this game, you want to break. So there are several use cases where an image group has to be clustered based on the groups you work with. Or documents, they need to be clustered based on what topics they are talking about. Or let us say you want to talk about grouping Twitter's tweets based on sentiment. You don't want to predefine that I only talk about two, positive or negative sentiment. But I want to discover how many sentiments are there in the tweets. How will you do that? Take the tweets, group them based on similarity of sentiment. Then you may say that there are five groups. Some are very angry, some are satirical, some are extremely negative, some are very positive, and some are neutral. So I said five shades of sentiments. I'm not specifically saying that I'm only talking about positive or negative sentiments as predefined classes, but I'm letting discover the shades of sentiment from the class. How? By clustering similar tweets, which are again what? What kind of data is tweet? Text. So that is only happening possible because of a deep learning technology known as word embeddings, which is basically help for understanding sentiments from text and very different words which have different spellings and different words but have similar meanings can be grouped together because of a deep learning mechanism called as word embeddings. But you see, same problem in structured data was doing one purpose, but it can be extended now to use cases which involve unstructured data also.